I'm about to go on a cruise, and I felt that I needed to make it the worst experience possible for everyone else. Period. I'm back and making videos. Travel some here, and you saw the clip, and I made the fucking QR codes. I'm gonna stick them to fucking walls. I'm gonna be crazy. I'm gonna be stupid. No, I actually plan on ruining everyone's vacation because I didn't have one. Almost forgot. I plan on making some Rickroll and other meme shit with QR codes, but I didn't have the time, so I just made my channel. Please subscribe. So as you probably imagined, things didn't go right, and you might say,
wow, right at the start.
Yeah, we were pretty unlucky, because we waited for 6 months just to get on board. They made us take a test for the virus, after checking our documents and making sure we were Mexicans. We finally got on board after a line. Fortunately, we didn't have to look at the next dumb fuck's ass, but we could look at a screen where they showed... At least it was an entertaining video. They finally take our ID picture for the cruise, so that when we gave them this shitty fucking card... Where the fuck is it? So that when we gave them the shitty fucking card, they could look at our face on their monitors and say,
yeah, that looks like you. Yeah, you can come in.
But you see, I didn't quite understand that, so... It looks like it was just a fucking mugshot. So after we get a feel of what's going on around it, and after we get told that we have to wait because they have to get our room ready, we go to our room, we look in our room, and there are shoes on the floor. So what the fuck was going on? So I alert immediately a crew member and tell him,
hey!
There's people living in my room, what the fuck do I do? He said, well, you usually call them friends. Literally, I don't know these people. There are shoes on the floor. This is all exaggeration. He actually just came along and said, oh, well, you should
change room.
We then went to the reception, where we wanted to ask what the fuck is going on in our room. We saw at the reception this grown-ass woman talking to the receptionist right before leaving, I guess. But she was unsatisfied about something, I don't know what, but she started crying. She was so fucking destroyed. And you know, usually that's a bad sign when you're just starting a vacation. Hall of Games? There's no games in this hall.
We're waiting for tickets. Still waiting for tickets.
They've just been fucking recalled. The fucking DJ knows he recalled all the shit.
5 car 3.
I see you be. I see. You be.
They made us go to the assembly stations.
And
for some reason, one for my room is two blocks above.
Day 2 starts, baby, and this is where things get funny.
Fred got Ligma.
The fuck's Fred?
What's up, dog? God damn it. I'm recording. Hey, do you know our word?
What's our word?
Ligma. Fuck. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. Yeah,
thank
yeah,
you
yeah.
Allowance to record me.
You signed a contract.
I did not.
Oh well, you're dead.
You're not getting out of this one.
You work for me, shut the fuck up.
I'm gonna call my lawyers.
You have no lawyers.
That's what you think.
No, that's what he thinks. Hey, do you know Howard?
Howard these balls.
I was just gonna say Candace, but actually I think that's how it works, so... look at you.
Bruh.
We came back from Pompeii and the security guard was Vin Diesel. I couldn't believe my eyes. He was there to protect us, his family.
Fuck you!
Candace, you know Candace? You know Candace?
Candace, balls feed in your mouth.
I was talking about Ken. Why did you do that? She's our friend!
We see for the first time the crew members cleaning, and gotta say, I love what they chose to clean. It was not just a simple vacuum cleaner. Some of them went with fucking proton packs from Ghostbusters, this fucking long ass stick, and just cleaned the ghosts out of the ship. I don't know what the fuck was the deal. I didn't think that many people died. Second night, and it was white night because we are racist on this ship. And this night I was dedicated to look like I sell Bitcoin. The only things you need to look like a Bitcoin investor, a white shirt, and jeans with your sleeves rolled up. You're gonna look like the Bitcoin investor. Put some on the screen right now so you can enjoy my Bitcoin look.
Just went to the gym. They have one on board.
Jim is my favorite character in The Office.
Hey, do you know what's an up dog?
I don't know who Jim is.
Fuck you. Ruin this for me. You always do this. Why? Why do you do this?
It's the funniest
thing. I will crack you like an egg.
I told you what you're gonna say. I will cry.
I will do that after I crack you.
It is.
By the way, crack on board is really hard to get. Found my spot. And so we're at sea, and since, you know, when you're not on land, there's gonna be less protection, they can't kick you out, I took control of the ship, and I made it do a sick backflip.
Whoa, backflip!
I annoyed the entire kids club of the ship, called teens club because we are not that young, with one single question. Gotta really thank Jay Schlett from his podcast, Chuckle Sandwich.
Would you rather have bacon, unlimited bacon but no games, or games, unlimited games but no games?
Now, this question was met in really separate ways. Women tended to choose bacon. Men were gonna separate another two groups: the dumbasses and the geniuses that understand life. Now, the geniuses that understand life have chose games. The fucking morons that I resent from ever living. Now, tell me, where the fuck did I say onion in that question? So this clearly shows that men are stupid, but not all men, and women definitely don't understand the question. Go to Barcelona. The beautiful city of Barcelona was only seen by the right side of the bus. You might be wondering,
hey, you know, there's windows on both sides.
Yes, there are, but our tour guide just decided that,
you know, I'll sit on the right side, so the right side is the only one that fucking matters.
She only pointed out things on the right side, continuously. It was like the left side didn't have anything to look at. Probably because there wasn't anything to look at, but you know, generally try and diversicate your path so that everyone can see something. Not that you joined the right party. You know, don't get into politics as a tour guide.
Go fuck yourself, French. Cart C. C.
Is nuts. Gotcha, bitch.
Thank you. Now, this 7 was the last day for us on the ship. It was really sad to see all of them go. You know, when you point the gun at them for all the travel and then you have to pull the trigger, it's just destroying, gut-wrenching, you know?
So this is the end of the journey. Through it, I learned that Just Dance is not for me and that I will never play it again. That people prefer infinite food to infinite fun and that crews don't know what good food is or they decide to stop it decent. Anyways, before the end, let me tell you that my uploads are not okay and that I don't wanna deal with it. And with this, I'll see you next time.